In this video, we're going to dive into the cut page in DaVinci Resolve 16, and I'm going to show you how to use it to edit a lot faster. Let's take a look. What's going on? Jay Lippman here. Welcome to yet another video. If you're new to the channel and you're into things like video editing, camera gear, and life as a full-time creator, make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit that bell so you can get notified whenever I upload a new video. This week, we're diving back into DaVinci Resolve 16. I want to focus on the cut page, which has been a topic of controversy ever since DaVinci Resolve 16 was launched. Some people love it, some people hate it, some people are confused as to why it actually exists. I am in that middle category. I absolutely love it. I've been playing around with the cut page for a couple weeks now, and it's made my editing workflow a lot faster, and I kind of wanted to dive in and show you guys exactly how I've been using it. And no, I have not been using it to create entire videos. That's not what the cut page is for. Now, you can create complete videos in the cut page, but they would have to be more simplified YouTube videos or simple broadcast news pieces where there's not a lot of transitions and special effects and titles and stuff like that. If you do create videos like that, if you create more complex videos like I do, then you can still use the cut page to scrub through your footage, find all your usable clips, throw them in a very simplified timeline, and then you can tweak it and make it all pretty in the edit page and in the color page and in the Fairlight page and all the other pages. With that being said, let's dive into DaVinci Resolve 16. I'm gonna show you exactly how I use the cut page to scrub through my footage and find all my usable clips. All right, so we're in the cut page in DaVinci Resolve 16, and the first thing that I want to do is give you a general overview of what I'm looking at. Over here in the top left are all of my source clips, and in the top right is my monitor. Now, in the edit page, we have a separate source monitor and timeline monitor. In the cut page, the source monitor and the timeline monitor are the same because we're actually, for the most part, only going to be messing with the source monitor. You very rarely actually need to go into the timeline monitor for what I'm doing. Just below that are a bunch of handy little buttons like smart insert, append, ripple overwrite, close up, place on top, and source overwrite. And then to the right of those are a few handy little transitions like cut, dissolve, and smooth cut. Below all of those buttons are your timelines. And like I said in my last video on DaVinci Resolve 16, the cut page has dual timelines. This top timeline is a bird's eye view. You will always see your entire timeline from beginning to end up here. Down here in the bottom is your work area timeline. This is zoomed in on the spot where you're working, so you can clearly see everything and make accurate edits. Now, like I said, I'm using the cut page to literally cut my footage. I'm going through my clips, I'm setting in and out points, I'm bringing clips into my timeline, and that is something that I could do in the edit page. Here's the issue. With the edit page, you have to drag your clip into the source monitor individually, you have to set your in and your out points, you drag the clip onto the timeline, which then activates your timeline monitor, so to continue going through your source clip, you have to reactivate the source monitor, go through, find a new in and out point, bring it into the timeline, and go through the whole process over and over again. Then when you're done with that clip, you gotta bring a new clip into the source monitor and all of that, and it really, like, you don't think about it because that's the way we've been doing it for so long, but that wastes so much time. The cut page gets rid of a lot of that, and it's because of two different tools. One is source tape, two is, well, it doesn't have a name. It's just a really cool feature that it just doesn't have a name. First, let's talk about source tape. Source tape is a way to see all of your source clips as one giant source clip in your source monitor. Does that make sense? Probably not. I'm gonna show you. To activate source tape, you just need to come up and click this middle button in the top left above your monitor. And now what you're looking at, if you scrub through, is all of your clips that are in your source bin. And if you can see over to the left, as I move on to a new clip, the clip that I'm looking through gets highlighted. Now, let's say that you've just done a whole day of filming and you're not really sure what you have because you just kind of turned on the camera and you started shooting. You were out vlogging, you didn't have a story in mind, you didn't have any shots planned out, so you just turned on the camera and pointed at something and just started shooting, which happens to me a lot. And when I do that, the first thing I wanna do is go through all of my footage, figure out what's A-roll, what's B-roll, what's totally trash, what's a time lapse, what's slow motion, and all of that stuff, and organize it accordingly. And that used to be a giant pain in the butt because I'd have to open up each clip individually and label it and blah, 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 blah. And now you can actually do that a lot faster because of another feature called Fast Preview. What Fast Preview is gonna do is it's gonna take those super long clips that you film, then it's gonna speed them up so you can scrub through your footage a lot faster and see what's what and organize it before you actually start cutting things and bringing them into your timeline. Now, to activate Fast Preview is really easy. You just come over here below your source monitor and you click Fast Preview. And it'll start scrubbing through your footage. The shorter clips will play at normal speed and the longer clips will be played sped up. It's a really useful tool. I can't really show you how it works here. One, because it would take a while, and two, because the screen recorder mixed with the fast playback is just, it just doesn't work very well because, you know, I don't have an editing computer. I have a consumer level laptop. We've been through all that before. Moving on. Once you've scrubbed through all of your footage, you know what's what, you've got everything organized, it's time to start cutting things and bringing them into the timeline. This is where that second really cool feature is about to pop up, and I'll show you that as soon as I make my first cut. Now, I know that my first cut is in this first clip that I filmed, so we're gonna go ahead and play through that. We want to be right where Michael T. Panetta is coming into the frame. I'm gonna hit I for in. I'm gonna scrub through. I'm just using the right arrow to scrub through until he walks out of frame. I'm gonna hit O for out. I'm just gonna hit smart insert, and that's gonna bring the clip into the timeline. Now, did you see what happened here? Take a look again. I brought a clip into the timeline and I'm still in source monitor, which means I can just come back up here. I can keep scrubbing through. I can find the next point where I want to make a cut, which is going to be right about where I'm opening the door right there. Hit a new endpoint. Come over to where that clip ends. Hit out. Come over here, hit append. And we've got another clip. And I can go through all of my dialogue clips and go ahead and just throw everything together. And then there's this. There's one more super, super cool thing that you can do in the cut page that just blew my mind when I saw it. Back in my last video about DaVinci Resolve 16, I talked about how both of the timelines, the dual timelines in the cut page, are active. You can edit in both of them. What I didn't mention was that they're actually active between each other, which means you can take a clip from your work area timeline and you can drag it to a different spot on your overview timeline and it'll move the clip. It's amazing. I'll show you. All right, let's say that I want to take this first cut that I made, this first clip of my camera being locked inside the car and Michael trying to get my door open. Let's say I actually want to use that as kind of a blooper reel after the end of the video. But right now it's in the beginning of the video. All I need to do is take it and I can click on it and drag it to right here at the end of the timeline. And now all of a sudden, it's at the end of the timeline. How cool is that? And that's basically what I use the cut page for, is just to quickly go through my footage, set all my in and my out points, literally cutting my footage, cutting all of the useful footage out and throwing it in a timeline, and then I can refine it in the edit page. It seems like it would be more work because you're moving between pages. It seems like it wouldn't save any time at all, but with this source tape feature, the fast playback feature, the fact that you don't have to keep reactivating your source monitor when you've dragged something into the timeline, all those little time-saving things really add up. And on top of that, honestly, there's a huge mental thing that goes along with that. If you spend all your time in the very beginning scrubbing through your footage, finding all the useful clips and putting them basically in the right order, then when you actually get to putting the story together, when you actually get to making those little refined moves movements, those little refined edits, since all of the stuff that you don't need is gone, since you've already cut away all of that and all you're working with is usable footage, you can move a lot faster, there's a lot less pressure, there's a lot, you can just get into the zone and keep going, which makes it even faster. So would I create an entire video in the cut page? No, absolutely not. Those aren't the kinds of videos that I make, but would I use it to scrub through all my footage, find all my usable stuff, throw them into a timeline that's at least in the correct order just to refine it later? Absolutely. I've done it. It's sped up my process so much. I love working with the cut page, and I think that's ultimately what it's used for. I mean, it's supposed to emulate the old film workflow, which this was the first step in film workflow. It was going through and cutting out all of the pieces that were needed so later they could put them in the right order and refine them and get the color right and all that stuff. If you want to know more about how I edit in DaVinci Resolve, I have an entire playlist dedicated to just that. It's linked below. Make sure you check that out. In the meantime, like this video if you enjoyed it, share it if you think your friends will enjoy it, and don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell if you haven't done so already. I will be back on Monday with a brand new video. Until then, thanks for hanging out, and I will talk to you later. See ya.